I got shot down by a SAM site. Anyways, this is the Wildlands beta area. I'm going to run across the bottom left corner of the map, and we're going to go clear across up to the top right. I'm just going to drop a marker, keep us on track. So anyways, this is where you're able to go throughout the beta. If you go outside those white lines you saw earlier, you basically, the game will just kill you instantly. But anyways, the data's there. You could go out there, but it's a 25 gig download, but for whatever reasons, they just, they made you download the whole game versus just the area that you're playing in. And then to just put, like, you know, code up to kill you if you wander outside. But anyways, this is some of the best graphics I've ever seen. It's, as you can see, just the terrain detail. This little stream here that cuts down through the mountains. This is pretty neat, touch of detail too. If you fly over these flamingos, they take off, you scare them. Here's where we gotta be careful, because this is where I got shot down last time by the SAM site, and looks like it's about to happen again. No! Alright. It's close. We're gonna swing wide left and see if we can get around him without any problems. And this is the edge of the map. I'm not sure if I can go over here. Nope, this is not part of the beta. Oh boy. Yeah, that's not good. Whew. Close. Alright, so we're gonna try going the other way this time. Once you get past this ridgeline here, it's not so bad, but there's a couple military bases set up there, and you can't... I guess we're gonna have to go the right side instead of left side. It'll give you a chance to see the detail on the sides of the mountains, though. We're going to pass back over them a couple times. It's kind of neat, too. If you're actually in the shadows of the mountain, it actually does stay darker. Some games, the lighting is kind of universal. But these mountains can actually make parts of the map dark, and you have to switch to night vision earlier on in the evening versus if you're closer to the top. I think we're all right up here. I guess we're still not out of the area. Come on. Whew. I can't believe I'm evading all these. Normally I would have been hit by now. Alright, so we're back in the area now. So that was the one province we were just in. You can see where it looks like it's really changed a lot after we've left. Looks like a missile or something landed over there. But anyways, you can tell there's a pretty big change now in just the environment. This is more of a jungle kind of environment, and then the other one was snowy and real open. This whole area here does not have any SAM sites, so you're basically free to roam around this place without any problems. Oh shit. Mistakes were made. Yeah, I'm used to flying the smaller ones. This is the first time I've gotten into this giant military helicopter. Get out of the way. We were close. Wait a second, what's this? Actually, there's another helicopter right around the corner here, I think. We can go fly that one. Much quicker, nimble version of that one. That thing's like flying a bus. If I can get up this cliff here. So I've only got this set to very high. There's one more setting above this, which is ultra. But the differences I don't think are that big. These guys are the rebels. They're part of who you're fighting with. The detail is just amazing. That's another forbidden area I just happened to pick up there. I can't actually go over that area I just discovered. You can discover stuff using drones or your binoculars or actually just go there, but all that out there is forbidden. If you try to go there, you're instantly dead. At least in the beta. The game comes out, I think, March 5th or the 7th, something like that. Anyways, helicopter. It's supposed to be right up the hill here. Try running up the side here and through the woods, jungle, woods, whatever. And yes, you do fight in thick wooded areas like this. And you sometimes also just run across literally like just ruins in the middle of the woods. It's pretty nice. This graphics are pretty amazing. Oh shit, way too far. So this is one of the rebel outposts. You can actually, once you start a game, you'll spawn at one of the rebel outposts, and this is one of them. I know there's a way down there. There we go. These are much easier to fly.
I got it. I'll fly.
One of the big criticisms of the game right now is that the flying mechanics are horrible, and they are. They're pretty bad. But once you get used to them, it's a little better, but it's different than any other game I've ever played, more different than really anything I've ever encountered. This is kind of why I didn't take this, because it's so fast, you can't really enjoy the graphics if you're trying to show somebody. We're only a couple kilometers, like a kilometer and a half away from the end of the map here, for the beta at least. And again, this is all just set on very high settings. Everything else is maxed out except the texture graphics. There's one more above me, and it's ultra. Just my graphics, my 970 can't handle it, and I'm running at 1440 resolution, so it's already running the hell out of my card. But yeah, this is the end of it right here. A lot of really neat weather mechanics too. They have sprinkle, they've got heavy showers, lightning storms, light fog all the way down to dense fog where it's just, you can barely see anything, just, you know, 10 or 15 feet in front of you. I was in a, I've only seen that once though, but I was in a house where the one thing that sucks is that you've got dense fog bleeding into a house that's kind of broke the immersion, but it was still good for this being a beta. This is the open beta, so who knows, maybe they may fix some stuff. But, yep, that's it. I just wanted to kind of cruise across the map and show you some stuff, and really good game. I like it. I have a lot of fun with it. The graphics are, like I said, best graphics I've seen in any game ever. And I've played, you know, Far Cry back when it was considered awesome. Back when it was, like, cutting-edge graphics. I mean, I thought those were good, but, I mean, this is just... I mean, it's amazing. The detail on the terrain, just... I mean, as you can see, it's just... You really can't tell, because I'm sure YouTube's, codec is probably making it a lot fuzzier than what it should be, but... This is definitely, better than anything I think that's out there. It's... With Tom Clancy's, like, The Division, that was another one, The Division was hailed for having amazing graphics. Now, whether the gameplay was that great, that's debatable, but one thing that everybody does agree on is that the graphics in the Division were really good. And that's kind of like these, it's the same situation. I'm sure there's going to be people bitch one way or another about, you know, the gameplay in this game, but... The one thing you really can't dispute is the graphics are just top-notch. I normally play with a keyboard and mouse, but when you get in these vehicles like this, it's especially the helicopter, you really need to use a controller, because keyboard and mouse are just horrendous. The control is already bad enough. You try to fly with a keyboard, then it's almost impossible. Something else that's really neat is if you're down in one of these towns and you see like these roads that kind of curve up and through the mountains, if you're down in these towns at night, the game does a pretty cool job at putting little lights on the roads, and then what they are, the vehicles traversing the roads in the middle of the night, so you can be way down in a village somewhere looking off into the distance, and a road like this one over here that we just saw, where did it go here, like this one right here, you'll see off in the distance, like, vehicles going up and down this road here, so, yeah, shit, yep, backing off.
Fire on these shitheads.
Else trying to run.
Anyways, okay. This video is already long enough as it is. Till next time.